The next two performances that you're going to see were born out of learning from our scholarship programme last year. We held scholarship auditions last May, and it became evident quite quickly to myself and the other musicians who were auditioning that we have a lot of piano players in Carlow. But these piano players that were coming into us had never played in any chamber music setting at all. They had been learning to play in their individual lesson. And I got to thinking, God, wouldn't it be just fantastic to give these young piano players the opportunity to play in a chamber music setting? Because any of us who play piano know that you very, very rarely play on your own. You're always accompanying somebody, or you're playing with a band. You're always making music with somebody, and that's what matters. So we had to think about it, and I thought, I'll start a piano duet club. And I looked to the community in Carlow for a partner to work with to help make that happen. And that partner is Carlow College of Music. At the moment in Carlow College of Music, Magella Swan and Gillian Daly work with between 8 and 10 young piano players on maybe every 3 weeks. They come together and they play. They read music together, they have fun. It's a very relaxed setting, always building their sight reading skills and their accompaniment skills. Next year, we're hoping that we'll extend this programme in partnership with Carlow College of Music to include piano trios and maybe even piano quartets. So we're going to take a little look. We paid a visit to Carlow College of Music to have a look at what was going on down there with our partnership and our piano duet club.
Carlow College of Music this year is celebrating 25 years of music making, and to date I'd say over half of the students are piano students, and the piano club really gives us an opportunity to share our skills, our piano skills, in a group setting, and the students really enjoy sharing those skills in a, as I said, a group setting, very enjoyable. And with the partnership with Music Generation has really been of benefit to us as well, and allows the students to be able to come together and share their piano skills.
One of the things we feel really strongly about at Carlow College of Music is group music making and chamber music. And as a piano player, we often don't get the opportunity to do that, like orchestral musicians. So it's a marvellous opportunity to come together, to play in a group setting and experience what it is like to play in the group with your friends and also with people that we don't know as well. So the benefits of this, I suppose, are accompaniment skills, which are so important as a piano player, because it's often something we don't get to cover during our individual piano lesson because you're so focused on the exam and everything that goes along with that. So I suppose it improves our listening skills hugely, our sight reading skills, and our skills, I suppose, anything to do with chamber music is involved in the duet club. And I suppose as musicians of the future, it's so important to be able to play as a group musician and to know how to play with other musicians and the skills that go with this. Because, I mean, what is music if we're just playing on our own in a room? We want to play together, and that's what we're doing.
Well, it's great to make music with other people, even if you don't know them, and it's also great to make new friends. And it's a lovely atmosphere on a Saturday evening, and I really enjoy it. And it's also great fun.
My sight reading has improved a lot since I've been playing, and listening to other people when I'm playing has improved.
So, we have 8 young players joining us on stage. You can see we have some kind of magic team behind this screen that manages to do that in about 3 minutes and get everything sorted. Thanks to everybody who's working backstage today. So we're going to give the students from our Piano Duet Club and our partnership with Carlow College of Music a huge round of applause for their one of their first public performances.
Thank you.
Well done, guys. Take your bow. Well done. Super playing there. Great listening. Great accompaniment. They've learned a lot. I wonder, is Magella around? Is she? I know she was. I'm not sure she is. Maybe we give Magella a round of applause. Magella has been working with these young people for the last year. Well done, Magella. Thanks. Take care. They're great. Great stuff. I'm a little bit scared sometimes when that's coming down. I need to make sure I'm right out here. So, moving on to our last performance. Our last performance of the evening sees our largest ensemble come on stage. So do bear with us. It's not our last performance. I'm sorry. It's not, totally. I'm way ahead of myself. While our next performers are setting up, what I'd like to do is to take this opportunity to let you hear about our youngest students who can't be here tonight because they're too little. Our youngest student is 6 months old, and he is part of our baby class in Boris, and our oldest student is 18. Our youngest students are part of our Little People Big Voices program. And presently we work in 13 childcare settings across the county. What's unique, I suppose, to this program at the moment is that we carry out a 30-week program with this age group, preschool age group. And that is, you know, it's a new way of working with that age group, because up to now they've tended to have maybe tasters of music or trying it out for a little while. But I'm really committed to making music a part of our preschool children's lives at as young an age as possible. We've big plans for our Little People Big Voices program next year that include an accredited course for our practitioners. Rosaline's looking at me going, really? Okay. and the establishment of two further baby classes in Carlow in partnership with Carlow County Childcare Committee. We're going to have a little look at our little people now before our next performer comes on stage.
We've had the Music Generation program in our setting for 2 years. Paula does various songs, music, musical instruments with the children. They learn rhythm and beat. It's really closely linked to Ashter and Sheilte, in that with the communication and well-being and their sense of identity and belonging. And there's also a lovely partnership with parents, in that they have a little performance at the end of the year. As a parent of a 4-year-old son, I value what Tyga's been doing over the past 2 years. I feel that he's grown in confidence, he's gotten more rhythm and beat, his voice as well. I think he's a lot more coordinated with his voice and body movements. I think they value working as part of a team together as well. Music teaches them how to work as part of a team and listen.
My part has been in the instruments.
What's your favourite part, Charlie?
Shaking with the ribbon.
Patricia has a drum like that, but it has like six steps to it.
different.
Okay, you can play that for a second and then we can have a chat.
Have the other part.
Okay. Like that bit.
Maybe one. That is, that's this moment video.
Anybody like to sing their name? It's always lovely to see yourself on a huge big screen. But that's our Little People Big Voices program. Obviously, they can't be here tonight. Next up, we have a fantastic young man who's part of our Outstanding Young Musicians Club. Brian Byrne is a phenomenal young piano player, and we're so happy to be able to support him in his musical studies. He's part of our Young Musicians Club that meet with our Young Composers Club on a monthly basis and are mentored by professional musicians, the Robinson Panoramic Quartet. Monthly, these young musicians get together and compose for one another and play and work together to develop their chamber music skills. Brian is playing some solo piano tonight, and I'm sure you're going to be blown away by the level of expertise this young man shows. Please put your hands together for Brian Byrne.
Thank you.
Wow. Good for you, Brian. Okay, well done. Okay, off you go. Well done. Good boy. Brian is 13. 13. Wow. So now we are actually on to our last performance and on to our biggest and largest community ensemble, which is Music Generation Carlo's Traditional Orchestra. There's 90 young traditional players coming on stage over the next few minutes. So I'll take this time to say some thank yous to the people that made tonight so successful. Obviously, our young people are what made tonight successful, but we do have some people working furiously backstage, as you can imagine. I'd sincerely like to thank Aideen Byrne and Orla Colleton for all their support to me on a weekly basis. They're quite extraordinary colleagues to have. I need you to give them a round of applause. I hope they hear. On the journey to tonight, I've had some fantastic support from David Ford and from Sinead Dowling. And I'd like to acknowledge both of your support and help in forming Music Generation Carlo, along with Carlo Music Education Partnership, and leading me and leading our group to the stage we're at today. So thank you to David, to Sinead, and Carlo Music Education Partnership. I'd like to thank sincerely Kilkenny and Carlo Education and Training Board, and most notably Cynthia Dean, our CEO, for her support of the programme, and to Carlo local authorities for their generous support of the programme also. I've mentioned our donors already. I'd like to thank Rosaline Malloy, our National Director, for her constant inspiration and positivity. And sometimes when I'm feeling like there's too much to do sometimes, and can I do it all? Rosaline magically calls at that time. And she always manages to inspire me and to inspire the whole team. And I hope she knows that. And I genuinely want to thank her for leading us all so well. So to Rosaline. So just to let you know what will happen after our fantastic orchestra play, a lot of you will have children involved in our last few ensembles. The children and young people won't be able to come out front here, but you'll have to collect them at the back of the stage where they came in.